I am back with more Project Zomboid. Now, I seem to have caught a chill. So, I'm at that weird point that a sweater is too hot, nothing is too cold. Oh, my life is miserable, there's zombies everywhere. Whatever. Let's put the sweater on and cheer up. And apparently I have cheered up because I am no longer unhappy. It was too cold to be sad. Now it's 5 in the morning, so I'm oversleeping. Of course, because I slept in so late the previous night, I woke up very early. It's kind of how it goes. If only it were like that in real life, I would have a much better sleep schedule. Now we're gonna... stupidly... I was gonna say carefully, but no, I did not do that careful at all. I just rushed right over. Check this area out. Now, I'm curious as to which building the alarm went off in. But it looks like it's a little bit... okay. It is this building right here. Or maybe the next building. Where is that one? Whose attention do I have? Okay, if I get in here, right, which I do, I'm gonna leave this window open in case I need to make a quick escape. This is not the safest spot to be right now. I am going to check these bins. A lot of people in the apocalypse may not resort to digging through the garbage. So there could be some stuff there. A gas can. Hello. Okay, let's unpack the tote bag. We'll put the gas can in there. Okay, that made it light enough to be worth carrying. So there is a reason to have extra bags. But with a gas can and empty bottles, let's check this out. Because I think that I saw somewhere that I can do something. We've got an empty bottle here. No. Okay. Not a problem. I thought I might be able to make Molotovs. But no, I guess not. I do have a tissue. I don't have any rags. I have bandages, so it's either not possible or I need something more specific. But I don't really know. So we'll go back in here. Alright, I just heard a bang on the door. Open it, walk away. Looks safe still. This appears to be a bit of a diner. So we're definitely going to find some food in here. Whether it's rotten or not, that is the real question, though. So we are not... well, we are disappointed, I would say. But it's not unexpected. So we'll take the chips. Alright, we got canned beans. More chips. A dish towel, which I'll grab instead of the fork, just in case the dish towel does the trick. Instant popcorn. As long as the electricity is still on, that can be useful. A pistol. Alright, we got plenty of ammo back there, but we didn't have a gun to go with it. A couple of TV dinners. I remember, my character has a voracious appetite, so he needs all the food he can get. And I personally happen to like carrots, potatoes, and strawberries. So we're going to grab that since we have three implements for farming. And then this is also an excellent container here. With bullets. I'm not going to grab more carrot seeds. One packet is really all that it seems like I need at this point. It has plenty of them. Duffel bag is now full. Got some chocolate. We're going to leave the dish towel alone. Grab more popcorn. Alright, same thing for those potato seeds. Don't need more of them. Accidentally drug this. Don't need a lot of containers. A lot of bags. Alright, what have we got over here? More bullets. This is a really nice find here. Alright, we are loaded up pretty well. So we'll just kind of look a little bit more, see if I can find just a couple more things. But I'm about ready to head out of here. I'm really loading up. Another pistol, I only need one. Teabag. Help me test that with the kettle. Okay, both bags are full. Alright, I'm gonna break out the plastic bag now. And since I am hungry, I will eat some chips as well. Is the plastic bag in here? There it is. Okay, I think we are ready to move. Yeah, I think so. I do pretty much want to just get back to that warehouse. We're going to call that a safe place right now. Not necessarily a safe house, but it should at least be a safe place. Alright, did not want that zombie following me home. Do not need any quote-unquote witnesses. I'm sure he's not going to go run until the zombie cops. Alright. What am I at for my weight? I might be able to carry these. Alright, I'm at my capacity. I will check these doors, see if they're open. Just to establish whether I should come back here or not. There is a zombie in there, too. There's a nice little mall right here. Very quaint. Now, there was a large group of zombies. Just north of here, so I do have to be a little bit careful. Okay, looks clear right now. No, there they are. They're all there. Oh, yeah. They did not all get drawn in by the alarm. So there are two very large groups of zombies in the area. So I definitely do not want to get overweight, over-encumbered where I am. There's a good old anarchy symbol. And whatever it says there, I can't really read. Give me a Dion a little bit there. So we are going to get back up there with plenty of time left in the day. And now we're going to run a little bit, because I do not think there are any zombies around. And if there is one or two, it might actually draw them out. and then I can deal with them singly later on, rather than having something like another house alarm go off, alerting the entire community to my presence, which I kind of did right there. So we'll just count to 10 to ourselves right here, and then we'll move on this direction. Hopefully we did not attract them too much. Of course, there was this place. I was thinking about making this my safe house. So maybe I will. I had kind of forgotten about it, to be honest with you. Of course, the downside is that there is no bed. But at this point... Ooh, there's another yawn. At this point, there's no real importance behind that. Of course, there's also no refrigerator. That is a little bit of a concern. We're just unlocking all of the doors and windows, so that if I want to come back in, I will be able to easily enough. That's not really what I was intending to do, I just wanted to close it again. But I held down the key. Yeah, I really need a different shirt, because this sweater is getting annoying. I'm too hot. I'm too cold. It's not Christmas. I don't know. I have a sweater. And of course, stripping the sweater directly from the zombie, putting it on my body with all its disgusting giblets inside of it, and putting my shirt back onto the zombie, because I don't want dead naked zombies around. That's just disgusting. And since it's fairly safe, I'm going to see if I can grab those nails now. Didn't see any zombies around. We're gonna run. Risk making a little bit of noise just to get there a little bit faster. And here they are. All these nails I don't really need. Just 20 of them. So nice to be able to pick them up that quickly. And that was the worst thing that could happen. Gunshot. Gonna cause zombies to move. Gonna get ready to start dropping nails. Be pretty funny if I could kill the zombies by dropping a trail of nails behind me. I don't see that happening. Alright, I'm in here. Now at least there's a couch in here. I can use the couch to sleep on a little bit more comfortably than other items. Okay, is that something I can open? Yeah, it is. There's just nothing in it. Alright, I'm gonna put the nails in one of these three containers here. We're gonna do a little bit of organization. Figure out a good way to do that. Alright, we're going to put our construction materials in here. Oh, but can I even cook in here? That's the real question before I drop too much stuff off. I don't think I can. I do have a bathroom, which is one thing. What about upstairs? Because I really wanted to kill some time by... resting. No, this is just an office, of course. There's really no way here to cook. Unless there's a microwave in the break room. There's a microwave in... Yeah, there is a microwave in here. Can I turn it on? No. Either there is no power, or it's not working. So that's not the best thing. But oh, I suppose I should eat. What I can probably do is just walk over this way just a short distance. And I'll probably find some houses. I don't want to go down there. It's where they had their lunch at the warehouse. Isn't that lovely? Because they probably got like a 30-minute lunch because they got to get back to work. They got work to do. It's a warehouse. Warehouses are busy places. Oh, we got a few zombies over here. Just kind of chilling out. And I'm okay with that. They can continue to do that. Now, maybe the difference between light-footed and sneaking is when you're actively sneaking like this, and then light-footed is when you're just walking around. So we're going to put the point into light-footed. We'll save the other point for blunt, because I'm pretty close to leveling that. Don't really want to do this, because the only reason I am doing it is because of the skill. I don't like it when I feel like I have to do that kind of thing in a game. I'd rather level up things as I go, just because I happen to be leveling them up. But in this case, I'll make an exception. There we go. Check these bodies real quick. Gotta keep moving. Alright, we gotta get out of this rain. I'm actually gonna run. Because I've been out here for a little while. I do not want to get sick from the rain. We're gonna move. We're not gonna run. Because there are other zombies in the vicinity. Like right there. And if I have one chasing me and he doesn't catch me, that's fine. If I have all of those over there on me, I'm not going to be happy at all. I can always grab a towel and dry off. Don't have one with me, but I can always do that. Okay. Really, I'm kind of surprised I haven't run across any buildings yet. I do not want to get caught out here in the middle of it. There's one. Got it out of the corner of my eye. I do not want to get caught out there in the middle of the night. But I am sodden, drenched, severely reduced speed, high chance of getting sick. Need to get inside. Need to get into the bathroom. Dry myself off as best I can so I do not get sick, because that is the last thing I want to do. No, that is not the bathroom. Unless I got the unlucky draw to find the one building of this size that has an outhouse. What do we got? What do we got? What do we got? Sheets. Bath towel. Dry myself. Alright, I'm just wet, so I'm good. Hopefully I will not get sick. But I'm going to grab these sheets. At least I'm going to try to. Hopefully I did drop off enough stuff so this will not encumber me. Okay. This was actually a lot farther away than I wanted it to be from the safe house. Very tired now. Glad there's no zombies on me. Managed to not attract too much of their attention at a negative location. Yeah, rotten food. But we've got chips. You can eat those. And then we're going to go to sleep. What was that? Thought I heard a thump. I'm gonna look around, see if anything dangerous is around. No, it looks like that's all there is to this, this particular building. Any windows in here? There is one window in here. I do have a sheet. I'll check out these two nightstand end tables first. We're going to move the sheets to my main inventory. And we're going to close up over this window. Add a sheet. Close window. Close curtains. There we go. That's what I wanted. I took the bath towels. I either did not use them to dry off or they did not get wet. So that is a positive. Get as much stuff into these bags as I can, because I'm currently overweight. Key bag weighs 0.1. I cannot fit that in any of these. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take something and leave it here. Or I could just eat or drink. I'll eat some potato chips. Doubt that's going to be enough. Actually, it was. So I will go right over to the bathroom, or actually we'll use the kitchen sink. Door's a little crazy in here. They don't have a kitchen sink. So yes, bathroom it is. Get a drink. And then we can get some rest for the night. Yes, indeed, we will sleep the sleep of the dead. Because I don't want to wake up, but I think I'm going to anyway. I'm sleeping well into the morning. Okay, we really do need to get back to somewhere to establish it as a safe house. Now I'm encumbered. I don't know what happened overnight. Add to my weight. I don't know, maybe this is a good spot for a safe house. There are a few trees around. Do not have an axe, though. I could always eat something else. 0.2. I have a lot of cigarettes, so we'll have a smoke while we walk along. Oh, I see why. I didn't actually drop my weight down. I just increased my strength, because when you eat, it makes you strong. It's just a little bit difficult to maintain that. So I've been in this house before. Now here's that fence. Now a fence like this is not going to keep any zombies out, because they can climb over it just as easily as I can. But it's a nice looking house. So maybe we'll make this our safe house. So let's go to the kitchen. Yeah, it's a good place. Let's start dropping off some food. I do not know if I can destroy things. Because, I mean, if I were living here, I would not want to keep the rotten food around. But we're just gonna stay out of the fridge then. We'll just stay out of it entirely. As long as we keep that door closed, we won't be able to smell it. So we're unloading all this delicious goodness. Not the pistol, the peanut butter. NTV dinners, which for some reason do not need to be refrigerated. More beans. We will put our cigarettes in here. Now it says gas can as I drag it over there, but it does stay as cigarettes, so that's fine. I need to remember that. Chips and chocolate. Now the big thing we have here is the gas can. That's really what's adding a lot of my weight. So we'll pop over here, open this up, and we're gonna put the gas can in there, as well as a few other miscellaneous things like this ammunition. Because, you know, it's always a good idea to store your ammunition right next to some fuel. And if I had some matches or a lighter, I would throw those in there as well. But we'll put some sleeping tablets in there. And hopefully something exciting will happen because of that. I was trying to. There we go. There we go. And then, next to the oven, we will put our drinks. Because I just want to avoid using the refrigerator, because everything in there is rotten. Yeah, we'll put the, cooking pot and the tea kettle and anything like that in my main inventory so I can fill those up with water, as well as the empty bottles. I'll put the can opener in there. A hammer. No, we won't put the hammer in there. Okay, hopefully that's not gonna have anyone go through this house. Get in here, we'll put a dish towel in the middle one. As well as some sheet. I'll put the sheet into my main inventory, because I plan on hanging that up over one of the windows. Really just trying to make room. If stuff goes in the wrong container, I'm not going to make a big deal about it. Okay. How much do these seed packets weigh? Nothing. Alright, I'm down to... Oh yeah, I got a bunch of stuff in here though. More ammo. Cooking pot. Oh, that's right, I wanted to use that to fill it all these things up with water. We'll definitely be doing that. That way I still have the opportunity to cook even if water runs out. Well, that makes sense for why I would fill up the kettle and the pot. Still not sure why you would want to fill up the pot bottle. So perhaps you could use that to pour from one container to another. Okay, is the sink... is water out? Because it's possible that the water is shut off or shut down, and I'm only able to get... Oh, hello. It's possible I'm only to use the faucet one or two times. You know, just enough to... establish that the pipes have run out. Sorry, not establish that, but to, I don't know why I'm having so much trouble phrasing this. To get all the water which is in the pipes out. Because there's always a little bit that does linger. Oh yeah, I was going to fill empty bottle. Fill kettle. That's two things. So yeah, it looks like water's out. What about here? Okay, so we're going to have a time getting water. We'll go back over here to get some more water. I do not have any food with me. Okay, that's a bust. There's a bathroom. Nothing there. What about across the street? See, the process, or the, it's seemingly like a bad idea to establish a safe house now without a source of water. Because even if I start farming, I'm not going to have water. For two reasons that's bad, of course. One, I can't water the crops and everything, but if I'm dead, you know, that's not going to do me any good. I don't want to be dead. Being dead is bad. And that does bring to light the extreme disadvantage of continuing from where you left off instead of starting new. Alright, we've got some cereal here. Eat that. We've got a sink that has nothing in it. What about upstairs? So they must have changed hypochondria, or I've just been playing the game very well. Because I have not had any of the fun effects from it. None of the worrying about, am I really sick, am I really infected, but I'm probably fine, but there's no way to tell for sure. So they may have made that trait a little bit easier to deal with. Which isn't really fun. I mean, the reason I took it was to have some fun with it, but it's just been totally neutral so far. Rotten, 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 rotten. Okay. Now, I do have a few drink items. And by drink items, I mean orange sodas, water bottles, things of that nature. But I do not like being out of water. That's rough. Because even if I establish an immediate safe house in a new game, and I had 2 months worth of water, Yeah, I would have to spend the whole time gathering up bottles of water and all that stuff. Like, that would be the focus. Like, being hungry is not even a concern. Being thirsty is. And I just wonder if there is a way to get water other than going to sinks and getting water out that way, or finding pop bottles and water bottles already in existence. Alright, here we go. We got the cooking pot. I believe it takes two units. No, it's full. Yeah, that sink's tapped out now too. So that is unfortunate. And everything is a water bottle. Excellent. Come on, door. Thank you. What do we got in here? Just a couple of things. A couple of sheets. We'll grab those. Oops. No, I don't want to walk there. I want to go to the window. Okay. Add sheet. There we go. That's what I wanted to do. Close window. Close curtains. Close this door. Close my eyes. And sleep. We are at 7 days, 12 hours, and counting. Our skills are doing well. Sneaking is ready to level up, but the skill point thing is a little bit weird. I think it needs a little bit of tailoring. That's just my opinion. I mean, maybe it works long term. But as of right now, there isn't really a long term on this game. Because you can't stay alive for very long. My record is 19 days, which I'm probably not going to make on this one. Because I have not been able to establish a source of water now that it seems to be out. Not remembering if this has been the second. I did record this right after the first one, and I don't really remember if this is day two or day one. On this video. Probably, I don't know. Well, it's not like anyone's going to demand their money back if I end this one a little early, though. So I may just do that anyway. Because I personally am getting a little bit tired now. Delicious zombie murder. Alright, let's see if they have any water in here. And then I will move on to the No, that's not even the right place. Oh, we got two sinks here. Both of which seem to be tapped out. As is the one in the bathroom. And I'm just gonna check one more building. And then I'm gonna... Oh, it's a garage. Alright, what do we have here? Nails. Nails. Wood. Floor. Nothing. Gotta eat again. Brought it upon myself. Think I heard something. Yep, I did. Cause now I see something. And seeing is believing. And I believe there was a zombie there. And there's a gunshot. I'm gonna hide out in here. I'm gonna get upstairs. If I can do that. Yeah, they're in here. Shit. Alright, I'm gonna end this one here. And I will see you in the future.